funnily enough, I started composing via practicing scales. It's something that maybe people don't want to hear, but it's the naked truth. I started playing the flute and latterly the saxophone, and I particularly got interested in scales, not just ordinary scales, but playing dominant sevenths and ninths and thirteenths and very technical stuff. And then I found myself writing these down and making patterns, making scalic patterns and arpeggios. And then I realised, actually, this actually sounds quite musical. And when I started joining these patterns together, I thought, hey, I've got to study here. And so it was a kind of a natural progression from then on to write music for the flute or the saxophone. But of course, all the while I was playing the piano rather badly and accompanying myself, if you like. And so I came to music, to composition very organically, not through any lessons. I've never actually had a composition lesson in my life, but it's literally through practicing my own instrument and learning harmony through a single line instrument, through the flute and saxophone. And so lo and behold, here I am now writing music for orchestras without ever having a composition lesson in my life, but having sort of learnt all these things, learning the harmony, and also listening to other music. You have to listen to other music. So by a very circuitous route, I guess you could say, I'm now writing music, and I don't know quite how it started. Well, I do, scales.